I don't want nobody else in my life. So darling, please pull me closer. This is the last time it could count down, baby.
Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm breaking down the Kid LAROI's featuring Justin Bieber's official lyric music video called Stay. It's a really interesting video that just uses stock video. So I'm going to show you how to create the text, the outline text, animate the text in, as well as stylize the footage, and then also do some rotoscoping so you can rotoscope out the objects so the text is behind the objects. Now, this music is copyrighted by Columbia Records, so I cannot actually use the song. So I chose a different song that's YouTube friendly, and it's called Gave It All I Got. And if you're interested in the track, I just put a link down below. That's all for the intro, and let's go ahead and jump on in. I actually found the stock video that the editor of this music video used. I don't know who edited the Kid LAROI's Justin Bieber's video, but I guess the prompt was, you know, find videos of objects exploding and then put text on top. But actually, all of the footage for this video I found on Envato Elements. And I didn't plan this, I just went to Envato Elements and literally searched for ultra slow motion exploding objects, and I was able to find the author on Envato Elements that actually recorded all these shots. So I downloaded them, and Elements is the sponsor of today's video. So if you are editing music videos and you want to start creating lyric videos, Envato Elements is a great resource because you can download unlimited stock video, you can get templates, you can get sound effects, all sorts of different stuff, and you can use it in any type of video. So it's really creative friendly. And Elements set up a 70% off discount code where you can get 70% off your first month using my unique link just down below, or you can just click up here to go check that out. So here in my timeline, you can see I downloaded all the stock footage here, and I've placed and cut the shots to match to the lyrical lines and the beats to the music. In the original music lyric video, you'll see that it has a film mat overlay with rounded corners. You can download some film mats from Envato Elements, but I've also linked to some free film mats that you can use just down below. So once you import the .png film mat into your project panel, you can drag and drop it over top the footage layer. And because it's an image file, you can grab the end of it and pull it out to meet the end of the sequence, so that way it's overlaid all of the footage. And so below this film mat, let's create an adjustment layer so we can apply a filmic look, because in the video it kind of has sort of like a filmish color to it. So let's go ahead and show you how to do that. Right click and select the new adjustment layer, drag this layer into the timeline, and make sure it's below the film mat layer. So from here you can go up to Lumetri Color, and you can make some adjustments to the footage to create your own film look, or you can even apply one of the built-in Lumetri presets. So while you can use Lumetri Color and it's completely free, it's built in, I actually prefer to use a paid plugin called Film Convert, because the film stocks really create real film emulation. It's really amazing plugin. And I've linked to it down below if you want to try it out, you can get a trial of it. And if you want to purchase it, you can get 10% off using my discount code PremiereGal. So just go to Effects and search for Film Convert and drag it onto your adjustment layer. And if you know the camera that the footage was shot with, you can choose the specific camera profile so it will calibrate the film color for that particular camera. In this case, because it's just stock video, I don't know the camera that they shot with, but that's okay. So I'm just going to use the default settings. Then from here, I'm going to choose the Polaroid 600 film stock. And then with these sliders just down below, you can adjust the grain size, the softness, and the strength of the grain. So once it's done, you can click on the little effects icon on the left here to see the before, and then you can click it back on to see the after. And I think it really adds a nice film stock touch. And as a final touch, I want to add in some film light leaks between a few cuts. I downloaded this light leak transition pack from Elements, and you can see here in my project panel that the transitions are just movie files. And when I drag any of these transitions over top a cut, you can see that there's a black background behind it. To remove that, you need to go up to Effect Controls, and beneath Opacity, you'll find Blend Modes. And this is where you can use the drop down and choose screen. And all that screen does is remove all the black, out of the shot. So I'll go ahead and quickly add in a few more of these light leaks throughout the sequence. And now when we play it back, you can see it just adds a nice subtle filmic light leak between a few of the shots. All right, so now that the look and the footage is complete, now it's time to create the text and the animation. So for the text animation, we're actually going to be using After Effects, not Premiere Pro. And the reason why is After Effects has a built-in typewriter effect and Premiere Pro doesn't. And secondly, After Effects also has a superior rotoscoping tool, so we can use After Effects to rotoscope out the moving objects in real time to place text behind it. So that's why we're going to be using After Effects. So to get all this great footage that we just edited in Premiere Pro into After Effects, I'm going to export this video in my timeline, and I'm going to choose the format H.264 adaptive high bitrate, and then export. And the reason I'm not using dynamic link to After Effects is because with multiple clips in your timeline, it just works better to export the full video. When there's multiple clips, sometimes everything doesn't translate perfectly into After Effects. So once it's done, you can import the file into After Effects project panel. Then you can right click on this file and create a new comp from the selection. And now we can start to create the text. The first set of text that we will make is just the title and the artist name. So go up to the type tool and type out Gave It All We Got, which is the track name. And the font that I'm using is Active Grotesque. And I actually found this font by uploading a screenshot of the text from the original lyric video to Adobe Fonts, and it suggested a bunch of similar free fonts to choose from. And while Active is not exactly the same as the original, it looks pretty similar to the original music video font. So now how to make this font a stroke only. This is where you're going to select the stroke box here and choose a white color. Then from the width, I'm going to choose 3. Then I'm going to select the fill box and press this little box with a red slash through it. So that way it removes the fill and it's just a stroke. Then I'm going to center align the text from the align panel. And next, we can create another text layer for the artist name. I'm going to type out Tommy Lundgrenberg, and I'll make this text size to around 80. For this, let's make it solid. So all we need to do is select the stroke box and then press the small square with the red slash in it to remove the stroke, and it will automatically add back in the fill. To adjust the position, I'll select a text layer and press P on my keyboard to bring up the position controls so I can easily move the text up and down until it looks just right. And now onto the animation. So select the first text layer you want to animate, and be sure to bring the playhead to the beginning of the layer, and that's when we want the animation to begin. So go to Effects and Presets and search for Typewriter. Double click to apply it to the text layer we have selected. And now we can play it back to see how it animates in. To adjust the timing, toggle open the text layer and open up the text parameter, then the animator 1, and then open up the range selector. And here you're given 2 keyframes, the beginning keyframe and the end keyframe. You can move the last keyframe farther away from the beginning to make it slower. Or you can move the end keyframe closer to the beginning to speed up the animation. It all depends on the timing and your music. So once you have it in place, then you can add another typewriter effect to this second line and move the range selector keyframes to change when you want it to come on screen. So when you want these layers to stop, to disappear, to move on to the next lyrical line, you need to make a hard cut. And this is where a really good shortcut comes in handy. Select both the layers by pressing Shift. Then you can press the Alt key on a PC or the Option key on a Mac, and then press the right bracket key to make the cut. And then you will see that now these two layers end at this exact frame. If you ever need to move frame by frame in your composition, just to move one frame over, for example, you can press the Command key on a Mac or the control key on a PC and use the left and right arrow keys to move frame by frame in the composition. So that's a really useful tool if you're looking for precision. So now you can just repeat this whole process for every single lyrical line in the music track. So you just create another text layer, just like I did, and you would apply the typewriter effect and then adjust those keyframes. So I've already created a new text layer and added the animation for each lyric in a portion of this music track. Let me just play it back so you can see what it looks like. Don't wanna say goodbye, yeah. Want your skin on my skin. Just one last time, if I can't have you, babe. I don't want nobody else in my life. So darling, please pull me close. So the text animation is done, and now we just wanna add that extra touch with some rotoscoping. So there's two moments in the video that I want to rotoscope. When the clock explodes and goes over the text, I want the text to be behind it. And also when the champagne bottle flies up in the air, I want to rotoscope out that bottle. So let me show you how to do this. First, let's duplicate our footage layer here by selecting it and pressing Command D on a Mac or Control D on a PC to duplicate. And then let's press Enter to rename this duplicate to Clock Roto. Now here we can scrub to the moment where we want the roto to begin. So right before the clock begins to go over the text here, then press the Alt or the Option key on a Mac on your keyboard. And let's press the left bracket key now to cut here. So that way the clip starts at this exact frame. And then we can scrub to where we want the roto to end. And then press the Alt or the Option key on a Mac and select the right bracket key to cut the clip here. And the reason I'm doing this is because we just want the rotoscoping to be on this one portion of the clip. We don't want the roto to affect any other objects. So that way it'll be faster just isolated to this one portion. So once that's done, double click on the layer to open up the layer window. And here we can select the roto brush tool to paint over the object we want to roto. So I'll just trace the clock here, and you can see it does a really good job at identifying the object's edges, but sometimes it's not perfect and you need to remove unwanted selections by pressing the Alt or the Option key on a Mac as you brush over the unwanted selection. So once you're done with the selection, just press the space bar on your keyboard and it will begin to process the roto frame by frame. And once it's done, you can go back to the comp window, and this is where we can then take the lyric text layers that need to go beneath the clock and bring them below the clock roto layer. And now when we play it back, you can see the clock flies over the text. So it's a really cool effect, right? And you can do this to as many different objects as you want. So I'm just going to fast forward here as I do the exact same thing to the champagne bottle. And once you're ready to export, you can just go up to File, Export, Add to Render Queue. You can change the file name and save it to a new location on your hard disk, and then hit Render. And that's all there is to it. So now with these skills, you can edit lyric videos for some of the top pop artists out there. Seriously, you just need some stock footage and a little bit of imagination, and you can create something that will go viral for the next pop artist. It's pretty cool. And thanks again to Envato Elements for sponsoring today's video. There you can download the stock footage that you need, download as many templates as you need for any type of video project, and you can get 70% off using my discount coded link just down below. And lastly, I just wanted to give a huge thanks to all of my patrons that have been supporting my channel over the years. If you sign up to become a patron, you can get freebies, you can direct message with me with the Patreon app, and you can also access my full scripts that I write for each tutorial. So that way, if you prefer to like go and read the step-by-step, you can see my process for creating the scripts for each video. So thank you so much to the patrons. That's all for today's video. And yeah, keep creating a better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye. Don't wanna say goodbye, yeah.
If I can't